In this video, let us discuss the chapter Set Off of Losses. In income tax, we bring all the taxable income to tax liability. When we are calculating income, the total income, there is a provision to deduct losses also. So the process of deducting losses from income is called as set off. So that is what I have given you here, adjusting the losses with the income in the same year. That is very important. The year in which the loss has been incurred, in the same year itself, if you are deducting it with the income, then this process is called as setting off of losses. So when you are setting off the loss, it can be done by two ways. It can be done within the same head or outside the head. Look at the second point in the slide. Losses adjusted under the same head, within the same head, or losses adjusted against other heads of income. So for adjusting losses, you can do it within the same head, or you can go outside that head of income and adjust the loss. Let us see this one by one. The first one is set off under the same head. So before going to set off under the same head, I hope you all know that there are five heads of income. Income from salaries, house property, business or profession, capital gains and other sources. We will see this one by one. Income from salaries. A salaried person can earn an income if he is going for a job. If he is not going for a job, then he will not earn any income. So when we take salaries, there is no question of loss. We will never incur loss under the head salaries. When there is no loss, then there is no need to adjust it at all. That is what I have given there. Loss cannot be attained. We cannot attain loss under the head salary. So there is no question of salary. There is no question of adjustment of losses under the head salaries. Now come to the second one, income from house property. Under the head income from house property, if the assessee has more than one house, under one house he has a loss and in the other house he has an income. So the income from one house can be adjusted with the loss with the other house. This can be done. That is what I have given there. Loss from one house can be adjusted with income from the other house. The next head of income is income from business or profession. So now for the purpose of set off, I am classifying this into three types: normal business or profession, speculative business and specified business. So when the assessee is doing a normal business activity or a normal profession, and if he has incurred a loss in that business activity, he can adjust that loss with any other business income or professional income or a speculative business income or a specified business income. On the other hand, under a speculative business, if the assessee is doing a speculative business and if he incurs a loss, then that loss can be adjusted only with some other speculative business profit only. It cannot be adjusted with any other income. I'll repeat this again. Speculative business loss can be adjusted only with speculative profit only. The next is specified business. Just like speculative business, for a specified business also, if there is a loss, then it can be adjusted only against another specified business. This is the provision for income from business. I will repeat this once again. For normal business activity or for a normal profession, if there is a loss, that loss can be adjusted with any other income within the head. On the other hand, if you have a speculative business or a specified business, these two activities, if you have a loss, you can adjust it only from that specific activity. The next head of income is capital gains. So capital gains, there are two types of gains. One is long-term capital gain and the other is short-term capital gain. Under a long-term capital gain, if you have a loss, then that loss can be adjusted only from long-term capital gains. On the other hand, if you have a loss in short-term capital asset, that can be adjusted both with long-term gain or with short-term gain. The next is income from other sources. Under other sources, I have divided it into two. casual income and owning and maintaining racehorses. So you all know what is casual income. Income from lotteries, card game, puzzles, betting, etc. That is all casual income. If you have a loss from a casual income, then that loss cannot be adjusted with any heads of income. Owning and maintaining racehorses, if you have a loss under this activity, then that loss can be adjusted from income from owning and maintaining racehorses. So these are the five heads of income. Income from salaries, there is no loss and there is no question of set off. Income from house property, it can be adjusted. Loss from one house can be adjusted with income from any other house. Income from business, normal business or profession can be adjusted with the income. Speculative business can be adjusted only from speculative profit. Specified business loss can be adjusted only from specified business loss. Under capital gains, long-term capital loss can be adjusted only from long-term capital gain. Short-term capital loss can be adjusted from long-term gain or short-term gain. Income from other sources, casual loss cannot be adjusted at all. Owning and maintaining racehorses can be adjusted only from gains from owning and maintaining racehorses. So these are the five heads of income. Apart from these five, one more item, exempted incomes. If there is a loss from the exempted sources, for example, from an association of person or from a partnership firm, if there is a loss, that income is an exempted income. If there is a loss from a partnership firm, then that loss cannot be adjusted from any other taxable income. That is, if there is a loss from an exempted source, that loss cannot be adjusted with any other taxable income. Now moving on to the next one, that is set off against income under other heads. So far we were seeing adjusted within the same head. Now adjusting outside the head. What is adjusting outside the head? After adjusting income within the same head, still if there is a loss, then that loss can be brought outside that head and adjusted with other heads of income. For example, there is a loss from house property. You don't have income to adjust that loss within the head house property. You can bring it outside the head and adjust it with salaries, business or provision, capital gains or other sources. This is called a set off or against income under other heads of income. Now let us see the provisions. Income from salaries, as I already told you, loss cannot be attained, so there is no question of set off. Next is income from house property. In that year, if you don't have sufficient income to adjust the loss, then that loss can be brought outside and adjusted with any other heads of income. So income from house property can be adjusted with any other heads of income. Income from business or profession. Again, income with business or profession, I'm classifying it into three: normal business, speculative business and specified business. Normal business or professional loss can be adjusted with any other income except salaries. That means a business loss or a professional loss can be adjusted from income from house property, capital gains, other sources. But it cannot be adjusted with salary income. Then specified business and speculative business loss cannot be adjusted outside the head of income. Income from capital gain, again, capital gain income cannot be adjusted with any other heads of income. That is, income from capital gain, long-term gain, income from capital gain, long-term loss can be adjusted only from long-term gain. Short-term loss can be adjusted only from long-term or short-term gain. It cannot be brought outside the head and it cannot be adjusted with any other heads of income. Income from other sources, casual income cannot be adjusted. Owning and maintaining racehorses also cannot be adjusted outside the head of income. To sum up, I have given it in the form of a table. This will be very easy for you to remember the concept. So, I have given you the heads of income and whether it can be adjusted within the same head and it can be adjusted within outside the head. The first one, income from salaries, I have put dash in both the columns. There is no question of loss under the head income from salaries. The next is income from house property. It can be adjusted within the same head and it can be adjusted outside the head also. That is why I have given can be adjusted in both the columns. then income from business or profession, normal business can be adjusted within the same head. It can be brought outside and also it can be adjusted, except salaries. We cannot use salary income to adjust business loss or professional loss. Speculative business loss can be adjusted only from speculative profit. It cannot be adjusted outside the head. Specified business, only from specified business profit. It cannot be adjusted outside the head. Capital gain can be adjusted only from long-term capital gain, cannot be adjusted outside the head. Short-term capital gain can be adjusted from both long-term and short-term gain. It cannot be adjusted outside the head. Income from other sources cannot be adjusted at all, can be adjusted. Income from other sources, casual income cannot be adjusted at all. Owning and maintaining racehorses can be adjusted only from income from owning and maintaining racehorses. Exempted incomes cannot be adjusted at all.